Are you ready to talk about mystery reads?
Hello friends, and welcome back to Bookmas in July, and welcome back to my channel, Wrestling with Books. If this is your first Bookmas in July video, Bookmas is a take on Vlogmas, the term coined by Haley in Bookland, where in the month of December, booktubers will post a video every day of the month. Since it is July, I thought I would do Bookmas in July as a take on Christmas in July, you know, because people always say that. Yes, no, maybe, kind of, sort of, I don't know, but we're here, guys. We're here and we're doing it, so,
Happy Bookmas in July.
Okay, so on this episode, I guess, or as the nerdy narrative would say, this episode of fun, I'm going to talk about some of my recent mystery reads. You know, have I already done that? No, I did my, sorry, I did my recent autobio reads. You can check that out. That was the first video to really kick off the Bookmas. But now I want to do some mystery reads because when all else fails, if you throw in a mystery, a thriller, etc., a suspenseful novel, those are all the ones I'm going to be talking about here. So I first want to give a shout out to, it's possible that months ago I mentioned this book, but I'm going to do it again now. It's A Deadly Affair by Agatha Christie. You may be thinking, I've never heard of that Christie novel, and that's because it's not a novel. It's a compilation of short stories. So, you know, remember back in the day, and I'm talking back in the day, where like print was a big deal. And I don't just mean print books, I mean like newspapers and magazines. And many good stories were published, you know, in the paper as short stories or in magazines and things like that. So this book, A Deadly Affair, takes unexpected love stories, is the tagline from the Queen of Mystery. But they take these, some of her short stories that have a bit of a twisted love about it, but it's actually, in today's standard, not really that at all twisted, but some are definitely surprising. We get all of Agatha Christie's favorite heroes and detectives. That's the word I'm looking for. I mean, we get Hercule Poirot, my favorite. We get Miss Marple, who I haven't read any of her books yet, but I really enjoyed her appearance in these short stories. So I want to read more. So if you don't know where to start with Agatha Christie yet, start with this so you can get a feel for each of the detectives. You know, detectives, I say loosely, like Miss Marple, I don't think she's like a legit detective, but she just comes and solves all the things. But if you want to get to know all of her main characters and whose books you maybe want to prioritize and read first, check this out, A Deadly Affair by Agatha Christie. It was fun. I would read like one short story every night. And now I'm going in chronological order, and I'm doubting myself because, you know, sometimes like I think I want to skip to a favorite. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to skip to a favorite. We're going to just go crazy here. That's my version of crazy here on a Monday afternoon. It's telling you about my books, not in chronological order. Okay. So I read The Thursday Murder Club, which is one in a series. We haven't gotten any of the other books yet, I believe, by Richard Osman. There are two reasons I wanted to read this book. One, reading Riley read it, and I believe she recommended it because it's here. And two, Steven Spielberg is going to be making a movie of it. I don't know how far along or anything has happened with that, but I guess I could look it up. What the hell? You know, we're already going crazy, right? So let's just look it up. Film cast. Ooh, here we go. Let's see. Yeah, I don't think we have it yet because I'm seeing art. Ooh, but gosh. Ooh. They are putting, okay, Ron Weasley's mother as Joyce the nurse. Love it. Love it. Love it. Okay. So, The Thursday Murder Club is about a retirement community. There is a man who owns the community, and we have four people within the community, two guys, two girls, who meet frequently, and they like to kind of relive their past. Some were involved with detective work and crimes, but the main woman we initially followed, Joyce, she was a nurse, she's newer to this community, and she's kind of the new person in this Thursday murder club because the one member is now in a coma. So that is sad, but she is the new one in the crew, and they just love to kind of be nosy and solve some crimes. But the developer that I mentioned, or the owner of the community, he is found dead. So now they all want to get involved and figure out what happens. So we get, you know, as I mentioned, Joyce, there's the other woman, Elizabeth, there are the two guys, then there is the actual people assigned to solve this murder, and how the Thursday Murder Club people intertwine themselves into an actual real investigation, and it's really charming and fun. I don't feel like I did it any credit by how I just spoke about it, but here's what I will say. It's not a thriller. It's not like a page turner. We're like, oh my God, oh my God. It's slow. It's, you know, but it's nice. It's a community story. You know those women fiction community stories? This isn't it, but it feels that way because they are all such close friends in a community together, right? And then you have murder. You know, you have murder and crime and people trying to solve it and mystery. And I found it all to be very satisfying. I think it's a great template for a future movie, film, series, etc. And I think you all would really like it. I do picture, gosh, I can't remember her name, Elizabeth looking like the person who's not Jane Fonda, Lily Tomlin? The person who's not Jane Fonda from Grace and Frankie. And I think I pictured Ibrahim looking like Christopher Plummer, and the others weren't like television people. But sometimes it's fun to say like who you pictured, right? Maybe just me, I don't know. So that is the Thursday Murder Club. It's a really, you know, more current popular novel. So sometimes they try to like, you know, fit in. Or just, you know, not fit in. It's not a fit in thing. It's more of like people like this. The masses like it. I probably would too. And so I was glad I read this one. Next up is a book that I got from NetGalley, which is Suspects by Daniel Steele. Yes, a little old person like me can get Daniel Steele books from NetGalley. So if you're looking for digital books and you like to review books, you should check out NetGalley because you can get some great best-selling reads on here. Oh my, this book, okay, it comes out, or it is just having come out recently. It came out June 28th, so this is a new release, and it is about, it's kind of cool. So there's this woman named Theodora who has started a really trendy fashion blog and fashion site. She has her own online shopping service and is one of the most famous people in the world. And there was a horrible accident with her family, her husband, who he was also in his own right, like a really wealthy, famous industry mogul. He and his son were kidnapped for ransom. The police and the investigative team took some risks that did not pay off, and she lost her husband and her son. So she's in the midst of a lot of sadness and a lot of tragedy. And at the same time, there is Mike Andrew. He's the guy from the CIA, and he's got a real nice generic name to go with like the kind of character he is. He is like your just generic older guy who's gonna be like the leading man, and it's good. It's fine. He's vanilla, but it's good. It's what you want, and it's what you want for Theodora. So something he notices some suspicious behavior, and the person is linked to Theodora's husband who had passed away. And so Mike decides there needs to be more security on this woman, on this case. He feels that things aren't done, and he's kind of getting this pull towards, and she goes by Theo, so he's getting this pull towards Theo. He doesn't know what it is, but he has this gut feeling that he needs to keep an eye on her. So in this story, we don't only see their relationship develop as he's focusing on her and trying to protect her, but we also get the investigation continuing on, and we get some answers as to what happened to her husband and son. This was another one that I would not describe as a page turner. It kind of just felt like a, like, you know, not romance in the super steamy sense, but just like a romance novel that had a mystery in it. It wasn't really thrilling, suspenseful, or page-turny for me. And I don't know if I felt as pleased with the end as I did with, let's say, The Thursday Murder Club, which I really, really liked how everything came together. The next book I read was another NetGalley read, but let me tell you, like, of all the NetGalley reads that I have read, this was my favorite of the mystery ones. And I'm more so, it was my favorite, like, because I was so excited that I got it, because this book is by Ashley Flowers. Ashley Flowers is the creator and host of Crime Junkie Podcast. Listening to Crime Junkie Podcast. They do true crime stories. So this book is called All Good People Here. It comes out August 16th, so you can pre-order it now, but it's not going to be coming out until next month. And it is about a case of January Jacobs. She is found dead in her family home, and we get some things that happened during that time. She has a brother. She did do pageants. She has, you know, it's very, very reminiscent of the JonBenet Ramsey case. It really feels like that inspired this, which almost becomes distracting, you know, where there's just like little changes where I think January, you know, isn't blonde and her brother is a twin and things like that. And also, what makes you think of the JonBenet Ramsey case's inspiration is the fact that in this community, the parents and the brother have been blamed of doing it. So, this book is about the community where this crime took place, but more specifically, a girl named Margot. She used to live across the street from January, and it's never been solved. And that kind of lingers with her, especially now that she is a journalist. So she has moved back home to care for her uncle, who is like a father figure to her, and has Alzheimer's. So if you don't want Alzheimer's and examples of how that can, you know, just really hurt a family and a person, then that could be a trigger for you. But I mean, also I opened up talking about how there was a child who died, so that's bad too, you know. So if you don't like stuff like that, then this book would not be for you. But we see Margot start to connect the dots between other missing or deceased murdered kids and January's case and her decision to try and solve it, despite the dangers that could come from doing that. Even though I loved reading this book, but I did find, for example, like I said, I felt it was too inspired by an existing well-known case. And when you get your ending, it's like, that's it. That's it. You just find out and then that's it. Like, that's it. No other page. Like, that's it. You find it out and then it's over. It's like, well, then what? You know? So I think, but based on how much I still enjoyed reading it, I hope Ashley Flowers will keep doing this and that she'll have other books coming out too. And I think this is a fun opportunity to check out a new mystery author, a thriller, true crime inspired. It's obviously not true crime because it did not happen, but it reads like true crime, and that's what I like about it. It reads the same way these true crime documentaries detail things out to us do. So I think if you're a lover of true crime, you would like this book. And also, feeling like, it's based on JonBenet. It's kind of fun to imagine that maybe this is her take on what she thinks kind of happened there. So that's kind of fun too. The next book I read is by Greg Olson, and it's part of the Detective Megan Carpenter series, and it is called Stillwater Island. This is another one I got from NetGalley, and I had gotten it so much before publishing that it had a totally different title too. It's just the mother and son. They're in a dark room. They can't see anything. There's nothing but a bottle of water, and the mother believes that it is drugging them to keep them sleeping. So that's all we get. And then we get Detective Megan Carpenter, and she is investigating these two missing people, the mother and son, from the husband. And the husband, she initially does not like, and his name is Ben. he's arrogant, he's snobby, he cheats on his wife, they were on a break, he's verbally abusive, maybe physically. It's not really physically as much as is told in the book, but it's a lot about the verbal abuse and control. So Megan does not like him at all and becomes hyper focused on him through this investigation to find Megan and their son. This book, you get a lot of Megan's backstory too as a detective, and she's a bit darker than most detectives we get. You know, she has her own sordid past, her own dark past, a type of past that could be bad if people knew about it. So you get sprinklings of that throughout this book. And this was another one where I don't know if I would, I didn't love the ending as much as other books. You know, it was okay, but it wasn't great. It wasn't something that made me feel like I was at the edge of my seat. And I also felt that she was getting blinded by her distaste for the husband and maybe not seeing everything else. But you as the reader, I don't think you were even, because you're only seeing through Megan's point of view, so we're only seeing that hyper focus too, and that I didn't like as a reader. I wish as a reader I could kind of see the bigger picture of what was going on. And those were the recent mystery reads that I took on this channel. I do have another one that is going to have its own review coming up because it was a NetGalley read, and that is called A Simple Choice by David Pepper. And I decided to give this one its own standalone review. So I'm just giving it a quick shout out here, but you will see it as its own video for Bookmas in July. Thank you guys for tuning in and for watching this. If you have read any of the mysteries that I mentioned, let me know. Or if you think you're going to check any out, I'd of course would love to hear that. Be sure to subscribe because I will be back tomorrow with another video for Bookmas in July. Thanks for being here.